Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today we're going to be solving the LeetCode question, Basic Calculator 2. Alright, so in this question, we basically need to implement a basic calculator to evaluate a simple expression string. So we're going to be given a string, which is going to be our expression, and it's going to contain numbers, and it's also going to contain these operators. So we have plus, we have minus, we have multiplication, and we also have the division operator, okay? So pretty simply, 3 plus 2 into 2 is going to output 7. So when you look at this question, the first thing is like, it's pretty simple, right? So what you would think to do is go from left to right and just do what the operator tells you to do. But one small catch that we have over here is we want to follow the precedence of operators. So what I mean by that is basically over here, when you have 3 plus 2 into 2, the first thing you're supposed to take care about is going to be your multiplication and division sign. So technically it would first be brackets, then multiplication, then division, or whatever it is, right? So in this case, since we only have these four operators, so the first thing we want to do is take care about all of the divisions and multiplications, okay? So, and after that, we're going to take care of the plus and minus, so addition and subtraction. So in this case, instead of doing 3 plus 2, okay. So this over here, 3 plus 2 into 2, is first going to be 2 into 2, 4, and then 3 plus 4, giving us an answer of 7. So if you just go from left to right, this would have given us an answer of 12, but that's obviously not correct, and we want the answer 7. So let's see how we can do this. It's not too hard, but yeah, let's just go through this step by step. Okay, so over here we have this, and this is going to be kind of an example that we're going to use to answer this question. So over here, we have 10 minus 4 plus 3 into 2 plus 10 divided by 5. So what are the first things we want to take care of? We want to take care of this, and we want to take care of this. So this 10 by 5 is going to become 2, and 3 into 2 is going to become 6. So now this can be simplified to 10 minus 4 plus 6 plus 2. Now, this can actually further be simplified. Actually, not really simplified, but just for the sake of simplicity, instead of writing this as 10 minus 4, so let's just write it as 10 plus negative 4, okay? By doing it like this, so by writing it as 10 plus negative 4 plus 6 plus 2, we have all additions. And now the final thing that we really need to do is just add all of these things together. So that's going to give us 10 plus negative 4 is 6, so 6 plus 6 is 12, and then 14. So our answer here is 14. Now that we know this, let's see how we can actually end up reaching this answer. Okay, so as you saw in the earlier step or what we just did, at the ending, after simplifying our multiplications and divisions, we just ended up adding everything, right? So that is exactly what we're going to do over here. So our first goal is to take care of the multiplications and the divisions, okay? And after we do that, we're just directly going to add everything. And for the negative numbers, we'll consider them, so for 10 minus 4, we will consider this as doing 10 plus negative 4, okay? So now let's see how we can do this. And we're going to be storing all of these values. So everything that needs to be added is going to be stored in a stack. Okay, so let's just kind of draw our stack like this. And the reason we're drawing it like this is because in a stack, what happens is that the last value you put in is going to be what comes out first, okay? So instead of like in a queue where you get the last first value, over here you're going to get the last value, okay? And that makes sense because we want the last or the most current number. So over here, we're going to have a variable called current number, okay? And what we're going to do over here is each time we're going to keep adding whatever the current number is. So this over here is a string, so do remember that. And we'll be going through each of the elements in our string. So first, let's go to 1. And since it's a number, we're going to add it to current. So current now has a value of 1. Okay, so now then we have the number 0. So we want to add this to our current number variable. So to do that, how we're going to do it, because we want to account for, so we can't just do 1 plus 0, right? So 1 plus 0 would give us a value of 1. But instead, what we want to do is we want to get a value of 10. So what we're going to do is we're going to do 10 multiplied by 1. That gives us 10. And then we're going to add whatever number we're on. So 10 plus 0 gives us 0. That's one way to do it. And another way you could do it is you could consider this as a string. So when you do string 1 plus string 0, that actually directly just gives you string 10. And then you convert that string to an integer finally. Okay, so anyways, there's two, three ways to do that. So over here, we have our current number 10. And we're also going to be keeping track of what operator we're currently on, okay? So let's just call this operator. Perfect. Okay. So now, the in the very beginning, what we're going to do is we're going to consider the operator to be plus. So I'll go over why we're considering it to be like that. But for now, let's just say there's no operator, okay? So now, the operator that we stumble across is going to be negative, right? So we're going to store that over here. Now, for the very first number, what we're directly going to do is we're directly just going to append that to our stack. So over here, we're just going to directly append 10 to our stack. So let's just add 10. So now we have 10 in our stack. Perfect, okay? And the operator currently is going to be negative. Okay, and after this, so since we already took care of 10, what's going to happen now is that we already got the number that there is, right? So everything up to a certain point, so in this case, everything up to negative is going to be the number or any operator, right? So now that we got the number, we're going to reset our current to be to not have any value. Okay, so now we go on. So now we have a number again, and we're going to add that to current. So now we have a number of 4. And after 4, we have an operator of positive, okay? So since the operator is positive, we need to update the current operator over here. But before we do that, we have to perform whatever this operator tells us to do. So this is telling us to perform subtraction. But like I said earlier, what we're doing is we're only going to, currently in the first step, we're only going to be considering multiplication and division. So since this is negative over here, we're going to add the 4 or whatever the current value is inside of our stack. But when we add it, we're going to add it as negative 4 because all we're going to be doing is going to be adding everything, okay? So adding a negative number is the same as subtracting it, okay? So now again, current is going to become nothing, and the operator now is going to get updated to whatever we're currently on, which is plus, right? So let's just go through this a little bit faster. So now our current number is going to be 3, and after that we have the operator multiplication. But before we actually do any multiplication, we need to first add 3. So we're going to add 3 right over here. Okay, so now we have a multiplication. So we want to update our operator. So now the operator is multiplication and current is going to reset. Now we have the number 2. So we have that there. And now we're going to go to plus. Now before we do anything with plus, the operator which is currently there is the multiplication operator. So what that's telling us, so since it's multiplication, we need to deal with it right now before addition. So what we're going to do is we're going to multiply our current number, so in this case it's 2, with whatever is on the topmost of our stack. So that's nothing else but making this 3 over here to be equal to 3 into 2. So that's now going to have a value of 3 into 2, which equals to 6. All right, so basically what's happening is we're doing the small operation over here before the addition itself. So now we have a plus, so we want to update our operator, and current also gets reset, so this becomes plus. And over here, we're going to have 1, and then after 1, there's one more number, so now this becomes 10. And after that, we have the division, okay? So division is going to work the same way as multiplication. But before we do that, we want to take care of the addition sign. So we since it's addition, what we're going to do is we're going to add the current number to our stack directly. Okay, and now our operator is going to become divided by, and current over here is going to be empty. Now we go to the next value, which is 5, that becomes current, and after that we don't have anything. So now since we are at the very ending, so over here at 5, what we're going to do is we have to divide 10 by 5. So that is exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to go to the topmost value in our stack, and we're going to divide it with whatever the current value is. So there's actually one more thing that I do want to point out over here. So we're doing this after we're done with this entire expression, right? So when we're actually writing our code, we need to come up with some sort of way that even after we go through all of the letters inside of the string, or sorry, characters, even after that, we have to perform this operation. So we need to do whatever the topmost value in our stack is and divide it by 5. So 10 by 5 gives us a value of 2. Okay, so now we have all of the numbers in our stack. And all we need to do with these numbers is add them up. So basically, all we're left to do is 10 plus negative 4 plus 6 plus 2. So this over here gives us 6 and then 6. So 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 2, 14. And that is the exact answer that we saw when we did it in the very beginning. So hopefully you understood the approach that we're taking. All we're doing is we're first doing the multiplication and the divisions, and then we're adding it to our stack. And if it's a negative number, we're considering that value or the number as a negative value. And at the very ending, we're just going to add everything inside of our stack. Okay, so over here, we're just going to end up defining a few things. So we're going to end up defining our stack. We want to hold a variable which holds the value of the current number. And we also want something to kind of hold what the current operator is. So this is the three. These are the three things that we need. And so for the stack, we're going to be using a list. For current number over here, we're going to be using, it's going to start off with the value of 0. And over here for our operator, like I said earlier, we're going to be starting with the plus operation, but I won't tell you why yet, so let's just leave it empty for now, okay? And one more thing that I'm going to be adding over here is, actually I'll just copy it over. So I will be having a value called all operators and another variable called nums. So all I'm going to be using this for is going to be for actually checking whether the current value we have is a number or if it's an operator. So over here, if something is an operator, we only have these four operators, so we can just check for it like that. And if something is going to be a number, it has to be inside of this set. So this over here has the number 0 through 9, and everything over here is converted to a string so we can make a direct comparison. Okay. So over here, now we're going to go inside of a for loop where we want to get each of the characters. So I'll be going through this by the index, but I'll tell you why exactly we're doing that, or it should be apparent, okay? So over here, we'll do for index in range length of s, okay? So now to get the value, so let's just call the, let's just store it inside of a variable over here instead of referring to it each time. So character is going to be equal to s at whatever index we are at. Okay, so now we have the current character, and over here we're gonna check whether our character is a number. So if character in nums, so nums is the set that we made over here. So if that it is inside of nums, then in that case we need to add it to the current number. So to do that, all we need to do is gonna be current number, and current number is now going to be equal to current underscore number, and a current number over here is an integer, so that's why we're doing it like this. So current number is equal to current number multiplied by 10. And now we're going to add the current character we're on. But before we do that, we want to convert it into an integer. Okay, so that is if our character is a number. So if it is not a number, let's just write else. And we're actually going to change the statement over here later on. But yeah, you'll see why we're doing that. So over here, we know for a fact that it is not a number. But actually, one more thing that we're actually going to do is over here, one other possibility that we might be having is the fact that we have white spaces. So to be more specific, what we're going to do, we're going to do else if our character is in, all operators. So we have a set over here which refers to all of the operators. So if it is inside of it. Okay, so this is just supposed to be if character in. So I don't know why I wrote is in. Okay, so else if character in all operators, then we know that we over here we have an operator. So over here we need to check for each of the four operators, and for each of them we're going to have a specific condition. So I'll just write them all down. Okay, so over here we have the four operators, so plus, minus, multiplication, division. So let's see what happens when we stumble upon each of these operators. So one thing I do want you to kind of notice is the fact that we're looking at the previous operator which we stored in the beginning, right? So that makes more sense, because even if you look at the stack that we used over here, what happened is, so when we were doing 3 multiplied by 2, the current operator was plus, right? But the operator that we were storing over here was the previous operator. So in that way, what happens is we end up doing 3 multiplied by 2. Okay, so kind of keeping that in mind. So over here, we have what if the operator is equal to plus? So when it's equal to plus, all we need to do is we want to directly append that value to our stack. So stack.append, and we're going to be appending the current character that we are on. Actually, sorry, we're going to be appending the current number that we are on. So current underscore number is going to be what we're appending to our stack. So what if it's negative? So if it's negative, we're going to be doing the exact same thing, but except that our number over here is now going to be negative, okay? So negative current underscore num. So 1 minus 2 is the same as doing 1 plus negative 2. All right, so now we have the other two conditions, which is multiplication and division. So in multiplication and division, we want to make that change then and there, right? So the change over here is going to happen to whatever is in the topmost value of our stack. So to kind of do that, all we're going to do is we're going to go to the last or the topmost value in our stack, and we're going to multiply that with the current number that we're on. So current underscore num. And that is the exact same thing that we're going to do with division as well. So go to the very ending, but instead of multiplication, we're going to divide it with the current num. So one thing I want you to notice is if over here it is plus, then in that case, all we're doing is we're appending the current number to our stack. And that is also what, we want to do when we are at the first number. So when we got to 10, no matter what the operator was, we directly just appended it to our stack. And that is exactly what we're going to do over here as well. So, and that is actually why we're starting off with our operator having a value of plus. Okay, and one last thing that we need to do is before actually going out of this, so over here, we know for a fact that we have reached a current operator. So in that case, what happens is the current underscore number is going to reset back to a value of 0. And the reason for that is because the current number that we were keeping track of is done. So we're done with that. And another thing that's going to happen is the operator is now going to get updated with whatever current operator we have. So operator is going to be equal to the current character. Okay, so hopefully you understood all of this. And at the very ending, all we need to do is we want to add up everything inside of our stack. So to do that, all we can do is we can return sum of stack. Okay, so pretty simple, but over here, we're still missing one thing. And this is a small thing to catch. It took me quite some time to figure out. So what actually happens is over here, once you reach 10, then you have division and then you have 5. So once after 5, you're done with the for loop, right? So you actually don't end up making this division at all. And that over there is a problem, right? So we have to make this division some way. So what we're going to do is we're going to have another condition over here. And the condition is going to be, so over here, this is actually an else if, but we're going to change it to an if condition. So if our character is in all operators, or the other condition that we're going to check for is if the current index over here is equal to the last value that we are on. So if it is the last value, then it's just going to be the length of s minus 1, right? Because we're starting indexing at 1, but the length starts counting at, we start indexing at 0, but the length starts counting at 1. Okay, so hopefully you did understand what we're doing. So if we are at the last value, then in that case, we are going to go inside of this. And no matter what, we have to make the change that whatever operator is asking for us to do. So in this case, if it was a division, we're going to go to the topmost item and divide it, okay? So yeah, that's all we're doing. And hopefully you understood those small two changes, okay? Okay, so I actually made a small mistake over here. So while we're actually doing the division, what we want to do is we would want to do integer division. So when I'm doing that, I don't know why the answer is not coming as correct. So instead, by doing this, actually, it's coming as correct. So yeah, do let me know if you know why. So what I'm going to do over here is take the last or topmost value inside of our stack, divide it with our current number, and then I'm going to convert this into an integer. So this over here should work. I'm not too sure why integer division itself is not working. But anyway, so thanks a lot for watching, guys. And oh yeah, one more thing. Okay, and another thing is over here. So for the time complexity, it's going to be big O of n because we're going through each of the characters inside of a string one time itself. And after that, for the space complexity, we're going to have a space complexity of big O of n, where n refers to the length of our string. All right, so thanks a lot for watching, guys, and yeah.